Good morning.
We're just checking out of our Airbnb in Seoul, and as you can hear, I am sick and I've kind of lost my voice a little bit, but we're gonna head to the airport and enjoy some lounge time. So we're basically just doing the trip in reverse. We have to take the subway to Seoul Station, and then from Seoul Station, we can take an airport express train. So it should be pretty quick.
Let's go.
Finally made it into a lounge here at Incheon Airport, but we have had a morning. Getting to the airport was no problem at all. Public transportation ran so smoothly, but when we went to check in, we were told that in order to go to Hong Kong, you actually need an exit flight, which hadn't been listed on any government websites that we had checked. So we had to step aside and quickly book a flight out of Hong Kong to our next destination. So it was all a little bit rushed because we had to quickly do research on exactly where we wanted to go next and try and find the best price. And I don't know if we've accomplished that. Then after that, we went through security. It was a long line, but it moved the whole time. And then we went through immigration and that was no problem at all. But it turns out that our gate is, it says 40 minutes away because we have to take a shuttle to another area of the airport. So at most, we have 40 minutes in this lounge to eat breakfast and have some coffee. It's just a little bit more rushed than we had intended. And we left so early, think, oh, we're gonna be able to take our time in the lounge and relax and do some work. No, no. All we have time to do is quickly eat, quickly film, and then get to our gate. Rachel coming to you from the future for our lounge review. As you will have gathered, we did not have much time in the Matina Lounge West in Terminal 1, and the only reason we picked that one out of the abundance of lounges in the Incheon Airport is because it was the closest to the shuttle train that took us to our gate.
So with that, obviously, it's a new lounge, and so therefore we have to do an all-new round of scores. So let's give it a go. We start off with food. This was really good.
Mm-hmm.
The overall quality was decent. The variety was wonderful, actually. Obviously, no a la carte service or anything like that, but in terms of what was offered, then you had breakfast options. You had some Western, some local dishes, you had a salad bar, you had a full range of desserts and fruit and all of that kind of stuff. So this was pretty darn good as far as it goes. So with that, we're giving that one an 8.
In terms of the drink selection, it was really, really good. They had a few machines that could make you any variety of coffee or specialty coffee that you wanted. They had a fountain machine that dispensed pop. They had juices, they had water, and they had even more coffee in cans, all so you could take it to go. They had wine, they had beer, they just didn't have top shelf alcohol, but all in all, it was great. So with that, we're giving it an 8 out of 10.
cleanliness wise, this was pretty good in terms of all the eating services, and anywhere where there was food, then it was pretty much spotless, and the attendants were very good to clean your plate away. The only thing was that there were a couple of obvious stains and scuffs on the walls, which was a little bit disconcerting, but that's the only reason why we've rated it down. We're going to give this a 7 though.
In terms of comfort, this was on the smaller side for lounges, so it was a little bit crowded with the number of people that were in there, and also they didn't really have comfortable seats. It was mostly just a variety of different tables with chairs. No loungers or plush chairs to sit in at all. So with that, we are giving it a 5 out of 10.
Finally, on the amenities front, then everything was pretty much there or thereabouts in terms of your standard package of stuff. The only downside was that for some of your more basic amenities, such as toilets and showers and things like that, you have to actually go out of the lounge into the adjacent corridor in order to find it. So it wasn't fully self-contained. But overall, all pretty good. So we're giving that a 6.
That brings the grand total to 34 out of 50, which makes this a middle of the pack lounge.
To Hong Kong. We just got some tickets for the Airport Express. The tickets for two people, then it's 170 Hong Kong dollars, which equates to about 30 Canadian.
We've made it to our tiny Airbnb in Hong Kong, but that's fine. It is clean and seems to be in a good location, so that's all you can ask for in this expensive, crowded city.
Looking forward to getting outside and exploring what the city has to offer. But until next time, take care.
And keep smiling.